नमस्कार, राज्यसभा टीवी के खास कार्यक्रम संसदीय विवाद में आपका स्वागत है। मैं हूं अरविंद कुमार सिंह। जब देश को आज़ादी मिली तो रोटी, कपड़ा और मकान, ये तीन वायदे हमारे राष्ट्रनायकों ने किए थे। इनमें से कुछ वायदे पूरे हुए और खास सुरक्षा का वायदा अधूरा रहा। देश की एक बड़ी आबादी कुपोषण की चपेट में है और तमाम जगह बच्चों की मौतें भी भूख से होते हुए सुनाई पड़ती हैं। लेकिन खाद्य सुरक्षा विधेयक इस दिशा में एक क्रांतिकारी कदम है, जिसे लेकर दुनिया भर में चर्चाएं हो रही हैं। खाद्य सुरक्षा विधेयक 2013 को लेकर जिस तरह से राज्यसभा में बहस हुई, आपने पिछले दो एपिसोड में देखा कि किस तरीके से तमाम सांसदों ने तमाम अहम मसलों को उठाया। इस एपिसोड में हम आपको दिखाएंगे कि मंत्री ने क्या जवाब दिया और अन्य सांसदों ने क्या कहा।
मैडम, इन ए कंट्री वेर यू डू नॉट हैव ए फिक्स्ड डेफिनेशन फॉर पॉवर्टी, वेर यू हैव नो एक्यूरेट डाटा ईदर एट द सेंटर और स्टेट्स एज टू हाउ मेनी पुअर इन द कंट्री एंड विदाउट गिविंग एनी थॉट टू इम्पॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट्स लाइक प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फूड ग्रेन्स, प्रोक्योरमेंट, स्टोरेज, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एंड विथ रूपीज फ्री फॉल, Congress is blindly and adamantly trying to push this bill. Government is pushing this without any guidelines to states and made regulations and without taking views of CMs into the consideration. Madam, there is also a need to revamp, modernize and strengthen the PDS in the country. Madam, this bill provides 5 kg rice to poor. I tried to find out whether it is sufficient. I had gone through the recommendation made by ICMR and NSSO. ICMR recommends that 7 kgs of food grains for children and 14 kgs for adults are required. Even if you look at the NSSO survey, it says that 9.5 kg food grains are required. Food security can only be given if the farmers produce grains. They can produce only if they see some profit in agriculture. We can give him profit only by protecting the MSP. In Andhra Pradesh, out of total population, 8.46 crores, 8 crores are covered under 1 rupee kg rice scheme. If food security bill is implemented, only 4.61 crores would be get benefit, and it puts an additional burden of rupees 2500 to 3000 crores on Andhra Pradesh, and the state requires 1.7 lakh additional food grains every month. I would like to know from the minister how he is going to do this, madam. I suggest the government not to scream the populism, but provide the poor with malnutrition food. In this bill, they are told that during the calamities, the government will not take care. So I asked to recommend this to standing committee of this bill, madam.
Now, Jay Prakash Narayan Singh ji.
खाद्य सुरक्षा बिल विधेयक की वजह से वित्तीय घाटा और ज्यादा बढ़ेगा। अगर आप कृषि को बढ़ावा देने की कोशिश नहीं करेंगे तो कृषि उत्पाद की किसानों को उपज का लाभकारी मूल्य देने की कोशिश नहीं करेंगे तो देश की अर्थव्यवस्था ही को बनाए नहीं रख सकते। सरकार खजाने से 1.25 लाख करोड़ का अनावश्यक बोझ डालने जा रही है, जिससे देश की अर्थव्यवस्था को बहुत बड़ा झटका लगेगा। अभी सरकारी एजेंसियाँ सीमित राज्यों में कुल खाद्य उत्पादन का 20 से 25% तक अनाज ही खरीद सकती हैं, बाकी उत्पाद खुले बाजार में ही जाती है। योजना आयोग की रिपोर्ट के मुताबिक कमजोर राशन प्रणाली के चलते 50% से अधिक अनाज की चोरी होकर खुले बाजार में पहुंच जाती है। इससे बाजार नीचे चला जाता है, जिससे किसान के फसल का उचित मूल्य उसे नहीं मिल पाता। अतः मेरा सरकार से आग्रह है कि इस बिल में किसानों की पूरी फसल उचित मूल्य निर्धारित कर गारंटी की योजना का प्रावधान होना चाहिए, जोड़ना चाहिए, ताकि किसान खेती में लगे रहें।
थैंक यू वेरी मच। नाउ मिस्टर श्री आनंद भास्कर रापोलो।
एंश्योरिंग फूड सिक्योरिटी इज ए वाइडर एंड ब्रॉडर चैलेंज। विथ दिस बिल वी विल नॉट ओनली अचीव पब्लिक हेल्थ, दिस विल आल्सो रिड्यूस द बर्डन ऑन द पब्लिक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन सिस्टम एंड द फूड कॉर्पोरेशन ऑफ इंडिया and its food storage requirements to be in the statute that the price will not exceed minimum support price for wheat and coarse grains, derived minimum price support for rice. We can ensure livelihood security to farmers, and this will also expand the agricultural production and the agricultural infrastructure, geographical diversification of procurements, and enhance the qualitative scientific decentralized food storage mechanism. Union government with this bill, with this enactment, is under obligation to ensure regular food supply of food grains to the depots of state governments all across the nation on formation of state food commissions. These state food commissions will protect hunger-stricken, provide food security allowance, and to punish those who err in the responsibility in delivery of right to food. And for success of food security, we shall ensure proper functioning of markets and the trade system in the country.
Thank you, Sir Ram Kripal Yadav.
Bahut dinon ka ye purana nara hai, sir. Jab tak bhookha insaan rahega, tab tak dharti par tufaan rahega. But chinta ka vishay hai, mahoday, ki hum ye anaaj layenge kahan se? जिस तरह से खेती के प्रति लोगों का रुझान घटा है, जिस तरह से आज किसान किसानी से भाग रहे हैं, खाद महंगी हो गई है, बिजली महंगी हो गई है, डीजल का दाम रोज बढ़ रहा है, मैं समझता हूं कि जो मेहनत कश किसान हैं, उनको फायदा नहीं मिला है, तो खाद का उत्पादन नहीं होगा, खाद्यान्न का उत्पादन नहीं होगा, चावल और गेहूँ मोटा अनाज उत्पादन नहीं करेंगे, तो किस आधार पर हम इस बिल के माध्यम से लोगों को खाद मुहैया कराने का काम करेंगे? महोदय, जो बिहार जैसा प्रदेश जहां आम तौर पर बाढ़ और सुखाड़ से ग्रसित रहता है, ऐसे प्रदेशों पर विशेष ध्यान देने की आवश्यकता है। महोदय, एक चिंता का विषय और है कि केंद्र सरकार के जो सूची है उसमें बिहार में जो गरीबी रेखा से गुजर बसर करने वालों की संख्या है वो कम है और राज्य सरकार का जो रिपोर्ट है वो अधिक है। इसको इस असमानता को भी दूर करने की आवश्यकता है।
धन्यवाद। नाम रामविलास पासवान जी।
सर, मैं ये जो फूड सिक्योरिटी बिल है इसका मैं पुरजोर समर्थन करता हूँ। नक्सलाइट का मेन कारण यही है, उसको खाने का अधिकार करते खत्म कर दिया गया। इसलिए हम चाहते हैं कि राइट टू फूड को फंडामेंटल राइट्स में जोड़ा जाए। ये जो आपने 5 किलो का दिया है इसको बढ़ाइए, ये 75% अमीर लोगों को छाटिए। जो भी गरीब लोग हैं, चाहे किसी भी जाति का हो, जो गरीब लोग हैं उनको सारे के सारे लोगों को एक बार जोड़िए, नहीं तो क्या होगा, भ्रष्टाचार फैलेगा। एक तरफ में 2 रुपया में मिलेगा और दूसरे तरफ में 30 रुपया में मिलेगा, एक तरफ में 1 रुपया में मिलेगा, दूसरे तरफ में 25 रुपया में मिलेगा, उससे क्या होगा, भ्रष्टाचार नहीं बढ़ेगा। सर, एक बात मैं कहना चाहता हूँ, एक होता है एक्ट, एक होता है फैक्ट और एक होता है टैक्ट। तो एक्ट में आप बना रहे हैं, कानून बना रहे हैं, लेकिन फैक्ट अलग है। आपको उसके लिए टेक्टफुली काम करना पड़ेगा, आपको उसके लिए क्या कहते हैं कि पारदर्शिता लाना पड़ेगा। आपने कहा है जो महिलाएं हैं, गर्भवती महिलाएं हैं, जो बच्चे हैं, सबके लिए आपने बनाने का काम किया है, लेकिन इसको जमीन पर उतारने के लिए आपको सशक्त होना पड़ेगा। आज ये पास होगा, पूरे देश में लोगों के मन में एक विश्वास का वातावरण बनेगा।
आरएस प्रजापति।
सर, मुझे समझ में नहीं आता कि जब भारत सरकार ये मानती है कि गांव में रहने वाला जो 24 से 28 रुपये कमाने का काम करता है तथा शहर में रहने वाला जो 32 रुपये हर रोज कमाता है वो गरीबी रेखा से ऊपर है, तो फिर इस योजना का लाभ कैसे मिलेगा, इसका क्राइटेरिया क्या है? सर, मैं तो हरियाणा से आता हूं और हरियाणा में हरियाणा सरकार ने ज़्यादातर लोगों के, गाँव में रहने वाले लोगों के भी पेड़ कार्ड काट दिए हैं, तो फिर वो लोग इस बिल का, इस खाद्य सुरक्षा का लाभ कैसे लेंगे? जनता को रोजगार देने की जरूरत है, जब रोजगार होगा तो फूड की सिक्योरिटी तो अपने आप हो जाएगी। सरकार की गलत नीतियों के कारण किसान को जो है महंगा डीजल लेना पड़ता है, महंगी यूरिया लेनी पड़ती है, ब्लैक में डीएपी लेनी पड़ती है। किसान जो पहले ही बर्बादी के कंगार पर है, कहीं उनका बहुत ज्यादा नुकसान ना हो जाए, इसलिए आज किसान को भी बचाने की जरूरत है।
श्री नरेश गुजराल।
Sir, the bill says that it will cost the country 1,25,000 crores. If you look at the budgetary figures, 1,24,840 crores were provided for PDS and other schemes relating to women and children. The Honorable Minister, in reply to my question last week, stated in this House that if the PDS was updated to 2013, it will cost the exchequer another 4,000 crores. This means that the total cost of the schemes which exist today, plus the PDS, if updated, would have been 1,29,000 crores. And now the bill says that it will cost 1,25,000 crores. So you tell me what is being given to the poor. Sir, my contention is supported by the bill which states that 54.9 million tons would be required for this act. Sir, I have a PIB release of 20th of August which states that 56.3 million tons is required for the food grains today under PDS, which means you are reducing it by 1.4 million. And then you are saying you are giving a lot to the poor of this country. Sir, the very, very poor of this country will be hit very hard because till now they were getting 35 kilograms per family. But now an average family of five will only get 25 kgs. According to the NSSO survey of 2009-10, the per capita cereal requirement of a human being is 10.7 kgs. Now, where will the balance 6 kilograms come from? The poor man cannot afford to buy it from the market, given the way this government has messed up the economy and the way food prices have gone up. Sir, already in states like Andhra, Chhattisgarh, Madhya Pradesh, and Punjab, we have our own schemes where we not only give cereal, but also dal, chana, and sugar, etc. A nation that cannot secure its existing food stocks cannot promise food security. So today, we have 20 million tons of food grain lying rotting in the open. This is the most amazing thing I've ever heard, that you keep food outside on the plinth, monsoons are coming, and you say this is scientific storage. And what does the government do? It says, we have planned to add 6 million tons of capacity in this year. Totally illogical. You have 20 million lying outside, you plan for 6 million, and then what do you build in the first 3 months? 3 lakh tons. It's a shame the way they are treating our food. Sir, today we are lucky that we have some food available. But what if the monsoons were to fail 2 or 3 years in a row? Where will this food come from? We have to look at the supply side economics also. And to ensure that our poor people will continue to get food, because this nation cannot afford to import food, given our precarious foreign exchange position. You have to ensure that the farmer gets a good price for his produce. This government claims that it has doubled MSP since it came to power. Sir, I would like to challenge them. Compounded every year, the rise has been 9% for wheat and 10% for rice. So don't fool the poor people of India, because the input costs have more than quadrupled in this period. Sir, I have given a notice to amend Clause 2 of the Act, requesting for the Swaminathan formula to be adopted, which means input cost plus 50% would be the MSP that would be given to the farmer. And unless we make agriculture a viable business, this country will not be able to guarantee food to its poor. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much for sticking to the time. Dr. Karan Singh.
Sir, for the first time, the elements of a social security net for 1 billion people come to the Food Security Act. Its important difference is now this is becoming a legal right. It's not only a giveaway, it is a right to food. Certainly grain by itself is not enough nutrition, but grain is essential. Without grain you cannot have any basic health. This bill is encompassing a large number of existing organizations and strengthening them. The building of storage facilities and silos all over the country has to be priority number one, both in the public sector and in the private sector. Do not leave it to the Food Corporation of India, which is not able to do it and has an unsavory reputation. Second is our transportation. We have to work out a proper system, a scientific system of transportation by truck and by train, so that the grains can move as and when required and don't have to be stored. It has to be computerized, it has to be modernized. Again, the public and private sectors both have to cooperate. And finally, sir, the distribution. The central and state governments must ensure that the highly subsidized food grains reach the people they are meant for and do not get sold on the black market. This is a very important thing. The Panchayati Raj institutions have also got to show this, because the cancer of corruption that is eating into our economy, eating into our society, eating into our polity, must not be allowed to distort this very great and historic program that we've got. It's a difficult path, but it is not something, there are no shortcuts. And we all have to do this together.
कई सांसदों का मानना था कि खाद्य सुरक्षा से जुड़ी हुई मौजूदा योजना से बेहतर कई राज्यों में योजनाएं चल रही हैं और लोगों को इस योजना के आने के बाद कई जगह पर नुकसान भी होगा। फिलहाल लेते हैं छोटा सा ब्रेक और ब्रेक के बाद दिखाएंगे आपको संसदीय वाद विवाद का बाकी अंश।
सर, व्हेन मेंबर्स सजेस्ट दैट द स्टेट्स आर डूइंग बेटर, आई थिंक वन इंपॉर्टेंट फैक्टर इज बीइंग फॉरगॉटन. The commitment, both financially and the availability of food grains, to be given to the states by the center is much more than what the states are spending.
ब्रेक के बाद आपका स्वागत है. आप देख रहे हैं हमारा खास कार्यक्रम संसदीय वाद विवाद. मैं हूं अरविंद कुमार सिंह. खाद्य सुरक्षा विधेयक 2013 पर हुई चर्चा में शामिल कई सांसदों ने कहा कि भारत की खाद्य भंडारण व्यवस्था बहुत ही खराब है. एक तरफ गोदामों में अनाज सड़ रहे हैं, दूसरी तरफ लोग भूख से मर रहे हैं. वहीं दूसरी ओर कई सांसदों का मानना था कि आज भी किसानों को अपनी उपज का वाजिब दाम नहीं मिल रहा है.
The mover of the resolution.
I had moved the resolution opposing the use of the ordinance issuing power under Article 123. But I am still struggling for a response as to what was the need to have an ordinance to cover up for this period. Sir, I had said that my party is in favor of the right to food, but I regret to say that it's a repackaging of all existing schemes and not an effective right which is being given as far as this government is concerned. I would therefore urge the Honorable Minister, when he replies to this debate on merits, to take all these factors into consideration and try and improve upon the bill.
Thank you. The Honorable Minister.
Sir, I wish to assure the House that the federal system of this country will be totally protected, especially in the case of the food security of the nation. Both the central government and the state governments work together, not only this food security bill, even the targeted public distribution system cannot be implemented effectively. Many members suggested there are better food security measures and projects by many state governments, like what is being now implemented in Chhattisgarh or in Tamil Nadu. Or my CPM friends from Kerala said Kerala has got a model project. Sir, I agree with that. But sir, the model projects which all of us like to be implemented are not the projects which can be implemented throughout the country, because from the state to state the character differs. And sir, when members suggest that the states are doing better, I think one important factor is being forgotten. Sir, the commitment, both financially and the availability of food grains, to be given to the states by the center is much more than what the states are spending now. For example, Chhattisgarh
Sir, the existing subsidy as per the TPDS to Chhattisgarh is 2027 crores from government. And the subsidy now we have to incur once we implement the National Food Security Order in Chhattisgarh is 2,910 crores, more than 883 crores that we are bearing. And similarly, the food grains, now we are giving to Chhattisgarh the TPDS system, that is BPL, AY, APL, is total comes about 11.33. And in the food security bill, it is 12.91. It's roughly more than 1.5 lakhs more. Because of the representation from various states, 18 states, which are getting less than what they're getting now, the Honorable Prime Minister has taken a very bold decision to protect the quantity and price for the next period. The Maitreyan asked me whether it is included in the bill. Maitreyan, it is the quantity is included in the bill. APL is linked to MSP, but because of your of the recommendations from the many chief ministers, including Tamil Nadu, our Karunanidhi, Balu, all our friends, Kerala people, we decided in the cabinet the day the bill was taken up in the Lok Sabha that it be protected at 8:30 for rice and 6:10 for the wheat. Somebody said that after 3 years we are going to drop it. Sir, we are not going to drop it. It will be reviewed. So you are, we have protected all the 18 states with more food grains and additional financial burden. 2009, exactly on 4th of June, the Rashtrapati made this amendment, this decision. Important. The next day, we sent the draft paper to every state. And I called the food ministers of the country 4 times. What else is needed? And except the 50 ministers, I met everybody personally and expertly. And in this house also, I met almost all the members of parliament, explained the position. And so, sir, there has been adequate consultation. Then somebody may ask, why you have taken the ordinance route? Sir, this draft bill was presented in the Lok Sabha in the end of December in 2011. It was sent to the standing committee. And standing committee took 1 year time. And standing committee went to almost all the states. Consultations were made. And finally, standing committee unanimously gave the recommendation. So because of that, we have to enhance to 75% in the rural area and 50% in the urban area, that is coverage is 82 crores of the people. Similarly, sir, we also decided to merge together the various welfare schemes like the ICDS scheme or midday meal scheme. That has a nutritional component and that becomes scheduled. And that nutritional component is decided by kilocalories. So we decided the pregnant woman, the lactating woman, the newborn child, the child up to the age standard as per kilocalories. This became a right. One of the amendments we made in the Lok Sabha that it will be hot cooked food. That is just to protect our young children from the big business houses and multinationals. The responsibility of the central government is to procure the food grains, store it, transport it, and make it available to the state governments at designated places. In 2010,
Our storage capacity covered and capped was total 583.86, which within last 5 years, we have built up to 751. This is a commendable achievement. And we will build up another 5 million before the end of next year. Many of them are using the cap, but it should be scientific. There are some scientific norms fixed for that. It is not the kacha. During the season, when the food grains come, we are bound to procure protecting the MSP price. I know FCI is a white elephant. It has got its negative points. But FCI is the only organization under the public sector which guarantees procurement of the food grains which come to mandis. And it is the only organization which protects MSP price to the farmers. So with these words, I request the honorable members to pass this bill unanimously.
Desh mein harit kranti aayi aur khadyan mamlon mein Bharat aatmanirbhar bhi bana. Lekin bawajood iske tamam hisson mein log bhookho sote hain aur ye khabrein lagatar surkhiyon mein banti hain. Isi baat ko lekar Rajya Sabha mein jis tarah ki charcha hui, jis tarah se khas suraksha vidhayak 2013 par sansadon ne apni chintayein prakat ki aur zameeni haqeeqat se waqif karaya, उसे लेकर सरकार का भी चिंतित होना स्वाभाविक था. और मंत्री ने जवाब देते हुए इस बात को माना कि तमाम कमियां हैं उनको दूर किया जाएगा और सरकार आगे बढ़ेगी और खास सुरक्षा की दिशा में सरकार जो कदम उठा रही है उसे पूरी दुनिया सराहेगी. इस एपिसोड में फिलहाल यहीं तक, आगे मिलेंगे किसी और खास एपिसोड के साथ. धन्यवाद.